Mr. Chairman, we have a video we'd like to play.
Mr. Chairman.
We have a video we'd like to play.
Mr. Chairman.
Ms. Dean.
I object.
What purpose does Ms. Dean seek recognition?
I object. I'm reserving my right to object to the video.
Why would
May I inquire as to whether the gentleman has followed the Judiciary Committee's AV protocol by providing 48 hours notice to the committee's clerk that he was going to use a video?
We provided notice. Well, first of all, there's no 48-hour rule. It's not in the committee rules. Second, we did let the committee staff, the majority, know that we had a video,
responding,
and we gave the video to him this morning.
Responding to the gentlelady's request, he did not. He did not supply the 48-hours rule. 48 hours notice required by the rule.
Mr. Chairman.
Then I insist on my objection. Failed to follow the bipartisan protocol, I insist on my objection.
An objection has been heard. The video will not be shown.
I appeal the ruling of the chair.
There's been an objection.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to speak regarding
That's out of order. This is not debatable.
Well, what's out of order is there is no rule that requires a 48-hour notice. That's what's out of order.
There is such a rule.
There is not. Not in our rules.
Mr. Chairman, what are you afraid of?
There is such a rule. You objected last year. You were told there was such a rule.
Mr. Chairman, what are our colleagues on the other side of the aisle afraid of? Are they afraid of videos of parents?
The gentleman was recognized for his opening statement. Is he finished with his opening statement?
I'm not finished with my opening.
I seek recognition for a parliamentary inquiry.
Proceed with his opening statement.
It's not a rule. It's what you said. I think the term you use is it's protocol.
The gentlewoman objected.
The conduct of the committee, rules do. That's not a rule. We had a video. We understood you had a video.
I seek recognition for a parliamentary inquiry.
Gentlewoman objected because you failed to follow the rule. Her objection is sustained.
Mr. Chairman, I see.
Does the gentleman have anything else?
I see. We had a recognition for a parliamentary inquiry.
I'll yield back in just a second, and particularly if you're going to recognize me.
The gentleman yields back?
No, I haven't yielded back yet. I said I will in a second. It's a video about parents at school board meetings, moms and dads speaking at school board meetings, and you guys aren't going to let us play it?
It will not be played. An objection has been heard that you failed to give the 48 hours request required by the rule, and therefore
what rule? Mr. Chairman, what rule?
You have to cite the
inquiry. What rule? Please present the rule.
In the case of audio visual materials under the leadership of my predecessor, Chairman Goodlatte, a Republican, the committee developed a written protocol for managing the use of audiovisual materials in our hearings.
Written protocol.
This protocol simply requires members to provide 48 hours notice they are going to use audiovisual materials. Until recently, this protocol was not controversial. It was a helpful tool we used to manage hearings and make sure videos played properly. The gentlewoman has objected to the materials because the gentleman did not provide the agreed upon 48 hours notice. Playing audiovisual materials during a committee hearing is the equivalent of introducing printed materials into the hearing record. In the normal course of business, we do not object to each other's requests, but members have the right to object if they so choose, and an objection has been heard.
Mr. Chairman, did we ever vote on that?
That's a clever written statement, but a protocol is not a rule.
Statement.
Mr. Chairman, obviously you're not going to let us play it. Obviously you're going to censor us, which is sort of the conduct of the left today, it seems. And Democrats today, it seems. I yield back the balance of my time.